Next fight coming up. Hollywood Josh taking on Rob Bomber Brown. Daryl, this is an interesting one in that you've got Hollywood Josh undefeated. Taking on a man who, Danny Donchev, excuse me, who is really going to be, it's not expected to do anything but make up the numbers this evening as Hollywood Josh looks to continue his fine record.
Oh yeah, you know, I've known Josh for a very long time, through the amateur circuit. We were training down at the same gym in the Lynn ABC down in the park, actually. So Josh has always been quite a character, I would say. You know, and yeah, his boxing skills are really second to none, really. Very quick off the feet, southpaw, you know, jabs, moves. A little bit of power behind him too.
And Danny Donchev just coming into the ring. Six victories, 87 losses. One knockout. Man from Bulgaria. Lives in Rose Hill in London. Last minute fill-in for this fight. Lost his last fight to John Wheatley in the middle of last month on points. He's a fighter that can go the distance though. That's always good for these young fighters to get tested in that way. And I suppose Hollywood Josh will want to try and put someone like Donchev down early to show that even these fighters that have got that steel and ability to take people the distance, he's got the power and the ferociousness to not have to worry about that, to not have to worry about going the distance, and to kind of keep up that swagger, if you will, of being undefeated and with an impressive victory tonight, Dan.
Yes, Josh is definitely going to come in and look for a knockout. I can't see him not aiming to hurt Donchev. So should be another explosive fight. Yeah.
He's described as a colourful character, Hollywood Josh. I think that's you, how he said how he was as well, Daryl.
Yeah, he is quite the character. He's a very nice guy, you know, easy to talk to, you know. I just hope he does well.
Former stuntman as well, which is where the Hollywood nickname, of course, comes from.
Yeah.
Flying around in the Tarzan movies. I don't think we're going to see too much of that tonight, but...
Well, I hope not. I want to keep grounded in here.
Certainly don't want anybody coming over the ropes over to our table, that's for sure at this point. Says he wants to show fans his personality. Let's see what he's got in the locker for this evening as he makes his way to the ring. Shades on the almost that black silk shirt I can see there.
I'm not quite sure what that one is, but
would you wear that on it? I mean, you'll be wearing that, I'm sure, later on this evening once we've done out in London.
Yeah.
Well, he wants to show his personality. He's certainly doing that at the moment.
Yeah, definitely.
This is the Super World Heavyweight Contest of four of the ring rounds. Is you see in the red corner wearing the silver shorts, weighing today at 10 stone and 13 pounds, in his 95th professional contest, from Rosehill, Danny Donchev.
Danny Donchev, as I say, brought in late on the card. He's got a task ahead of him tonight.
And his opponent across the ring in the blue corner, wearing the red shorts, with a record of 3 victories from 3 contests, weighing in today at 11 stone, from
Marlowe,
Hollywood, Josh Eddie
Bogey. Josh would really be able to outbox his opponent and just get the job done.
And he likes to try and make his opponents look silly, in his own words. If you were facing somebody like that, that's something you certainly don't want to do in the ring, be made to look the fool. But imagine he's going to try and have some fun tonight, that's for sure. The home crowd behind him here at York Hall.
It looks like he's having fun with his wardrobe as well.
I've always said, you've got to make sure you've got clothing you can, you know, get off with the gloves still on, kind of thing.
Your timekeeper, Bob Edgeworth from Bromley, your referee, Lee Cook from Bedford. This is a super welterweight contest of four arena rounds.
Well, you wouldn't put it past him to keep the shirt on and fight, that's for sure.
He also looks in incredible shape as well.
He certainly looks prepared for this one. I suppose as well, having the shades on almost hides the eyes coming into the ring, but with the shades off, he looks focused and ready to go. No sign of fear or anxiety.
Yeah, you know, some people fighting, initially when they first come out, where the nerves might be, and maybe that's why he does wear the shades. You know, doesn't see the crowd, doesn't look at anyone, you know, he just walks straight through.
How difficult is it when you've prepared for perhaps somebody else and then suddenly there is the last minute change, if you will? Does that take you off your game slightly as you come out, a quick game plan change, or do you just go with it and try and control the fight as quickly as possible?
I think you've just got to go with it, you know, at the end of the day, we're fighters, you know, and things can change in the middle of a fight. You know, that person you prepared for could come out and do something completely different than what you've watched.
Cathy Brown down in Hollywood Josh's corner. Immediately just encouraging her fighter.
There.
Also southpaw as well, Hollywood Josh. Might make it a little more difficult for his opponent. Donchev certainly playing second fiddle at the moment. As Hollywood goes down right with the leading hand. Almost a bit scattish by the Bulgarian, trying to avoid everything without really firing too much back. I suppose, Darren, it's going to be tough for him as well in terms of being asked to just step in at the last minute. Little time to prepare and get physically or mentally sorted for this.
Yeah, exactly that. He's probably not as fit as he would like to be. You know, that was a nice shot.
It's not that rusty.
Well, that's the opening on the southpaw. You know, that straight right hand down the middle. You know, that's the trump card, I call it.
Good strong volley towards the top of the head, and Donchev is trying to almost duck out of it.
Yeah, I don't think he was hurt with that punch. No, I don't think he was hurt. I think he just knocked off balance there.
He's crouching so low to avoid a hit.
Yeah.
It's easy for him to be rocked back onto the ropes and hit the deck. Very quick count, he's back on his feet and looking fine. Trying to get aggressive, big wild swing there by Josh with the left hook. As he said, Darrell, Chev is looking to get down the middle at times and do that very physically and aggressively when he does. Feedback, the 29-year-old from those in his corner.
Nah, sure, he got wobbled there. Okay.
Chev ducking out of the way. Trying to keep some distance. He's almost wincing there, it looked on his face, though. The Bulgarian, he doesn't look in a great way going back to the corner.
No, I saw that. He damaged his hand with a shot. He tried to
coming round with the right.
Hollywood Josh.
Relax.
In pain. Don't look for excuses. Wasn't a convincing round, Danny Donchev, that's for sure.
No, not at all.
What about the constant feedback that we're hearing from Hollywood Josh's corner. Darryl, do you like that sort of
being
talked through the fight, if you will, by your team and by coaches?
Yeah, you know, that's the perfect cornering, I think. You know, that's second to none there. You know, that's what you need. A lot of fighters, they need that, you know, they're through this voice. Can just
kind of gives you a bit of guidance as well if you're feeling a little fuzzy in any way. Perhaps they're seeing something that you're not when you're in the ring as
yeah,
well.
Yeah, definitely that.
Round two then. Round four. Donchev has been rocked a couple of times.
Hollywood's got that very slinky fighting style, you know. Deceiving. His arm range looks very deceiving. It doesn't look like his arms are actually that long.
Oh, he's taking a shot down in the...
That may have been a low blow, maybe. Looks like it. Looks like he's holding his groin.
I think that might have caught him in a slightly unpleasant place, shall we say. Just came down low. Donchev comes out swinging and... count as a knockdown, and he's going to be counted. I think again it's just being off balance though, more than anything else, as he came in with a huge right coming straight back out from the corner.
Yeah, he's getting desperate now. He's boxing very wildly.
Does that, do you think, because if he has taken a knock, he knows it's only going to get a chance of one punch and he's not going to be able to stay in this fight for too much longer?
Yeah, I think so. Nice body shot right there.
Another low shot. Hollywood being told to just keep it a little higher. Nice left to the side of the face. Another shot underneath, and again. Donchev looks in pain. And that seemed quite low.
I don't think that was low.
Donchev is trying to plead his case to the referee. Hollywood is continuing to work the body when he can. Donchev looks a frustrated fighter at the moment, and Josh is just starting to up it a little more. Trying to keep the tempo and keep the pressure up with under a minute to go in the round.
Lovely, that was good, Josh.
Down to the bottom, left shot. Strong one down the middle as well. Donchev is hardly escaping these efforts. That's it. It is being all done and dusted in a rather unspectacular fashion.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure what Donchev was.
Looks like he'd just taken too many shots around the body. And Donchev almost saying he wanted a timeout midway through the round with still about 20 seconds left on the clock or so. That is it. Over to Mark Schmidt.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 2 minutes and 25 seconds of round three, the referee stopped the contest with Donchev in no position to defend himself. Your winner and still unbeaten, promoter of Hollywood, Josh.
There's the confirmation. Fine victory. Well, let's go ringside to Sophia, who is with Hollywood Josh after another fantastic victory to go 4-0. Sophia.
Josh, congratulations. That was your fourth pro fight. You remain unbeaten in your second KO. You must be delighted with that.
Thank you very much. First of all, I want to thank Female Lands Healing and Deliverance Ministries. Prayers and support, I appreciate that. Fight Club, Carl, Kevin Guy, Boxology, Kathy, Frank Sarfa.
So were you pleased with that performance?
Do you know what? I wasn't pleased at all, you know. I really didn't get to warm up properly. I just had to go out there and really box off instincts. But a lot of the stuff we were working on, I saw it coming out, but it was a bit scrappy. But we got the win. That was important.
It was a late change of opponent. Was that disruptive at all to your plan?
It's never disruptive because it's a learning curve. So we've always got to be flexible and ready to adjust to anyone. So at this stage, it's not really about the opponent. It's about your preparation and adjusting to whoever's there. So maybe that's even good for experience.
Mickey, that was his second KO. Are you excited to see what else he can produce for you?
A good start. Being busy, four wins out of four, can't ask any more than that.
not a young guy, so we've got to move forwards, but still plenty of time, so all good.
Listen,
Mickey really has looked after me. He's kept me in there. And also a quick shout out to Champs Barbers, obviously, keeping the haircut fresh.
Okay, well done.